Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss the precise definition of a limit. Here you see the definition on the screen. The limit of f of x as x approaches a equal to L means for every epsilon greater than 0, there exists a delta greater than 0, such that if the absolute value of x minus a is less than delta, then the absolute value of f of x minus L is less than epsilon. So what this really means, this absolute value of x minus a, this is basically saying if the distance between x and a is less than delta, then the distance between f of x and L is less than epsilon. In other words, when x is close to a, f of x is close to L, because we can make these distances as small as we like. Let's go ahead and do a careful example where we carefully use this definition to prove a limit exists and is equal to a certain number. We're going to prove that the limit of 3x plus 4 as x approaches 2 is equal to 10. Let's go ahead and go through this. So to do this, we're going to do it in two parts. First, we're going to figure out how to prove it. Let's call that the scratch work. I'll just write scratch work. And then we're going to actually write the proof. So when you're doing the scratch work in these problems, the first step is to identify everything that you have. In our particular case, a is equal to 2, and f of x is 3x plus 4, and our L is 10. So now we just basically write down the definition. We have the absolute value of x minus a less than delta. So for us, that's the absolute value of x minus 2 less than delta. The second piece says the absolute value of f of x minus L is less than epsilon. So for us, that's going to be the absolute value of 3x plus 4 and then minus L. So our L is 10, so minus 10, and that's less than epsilon. So again, step one is you just basically identify your a, which is 2 in this case. F of x is 3x plus 4 and L is 10. Then you just write down the definition. So we have the absolute value of x minus 2 less than delta and the absolute value of f of x minus L, which is 3x plus 4 minus 10, and that's less than epsilon. Then you just keep simplifying. So 3x minus 6, because 4 minus 10 is 6, and that's less than epsilon. And the goal is to basically come up with the absolute value of x minus 2. So we're almost there. We have the absolute value of 3x minus 6. We can pull out a 3, and then we get the absolute value of x minus 2, and that's less than epsilon. Almost there. The only thing we have here that shouldn't be here is this 3. Since the absolute value is being multiplied by 3, we can divide by 3. Divide by 3. And beautiful, now we get the absolute value of x minus 2 is less than epsilon over 3. Okay, so now using matching, we can see that delta is equal to epsilon over 3. I'm going to clearly write that down because that's very important. That's the whole goal of the scratch work. It's to find your delta. Once you have your delta from your scratch work, you can go on and write your proof. Okay, let's go ahead and write the proof. In order to write the proof, you want to fall back on the definition every single time. So in the definition, it says for every epsilon greater than 0. So you want to start by specifying that. There's lots of ways of doing that, so people will do it differently. I will say, let epsilon be greater than 0. The next part of the definition says there exists a delta greater than 0. So we just basically have to specify our delta. So we're going to say choose delta equals epsilon over 3. And this exists because epsilon is a positive number. And so if you divide it by 3, you get a positive number. So I'm going to specify that it's positive. You can always start your proofs exactly with this same language. You can just say let epsilon be greater than 0 and then choose delta equals epsilon over 3 or whatever your epsilon ends up being. Now we have to go to the next part of the definition. A part that says if the absolute value of x minus a is less than delta. So we write that down. So then, if the absolute value of x minus, so instead of a in this case, it's 2. And now we have the part with the absolute value of f of x minus l. So we already did it in our scratch work, so we just write it again. 3x plus 4 minus 10. Huge word of caution here. Do not write less than epsilon. Even though you did it in your scratch work, that's why it was scratch work. We have to actually prove that it's less than epsilon. So if you write down less than epsilon, it's completely wrong. You actually have to show it's less than epsilon. In order to do that, you basically retrace your steps. So this is equal to the absolute value of 3x minus 6. And then just like before, we can factor out a 3. So this is 3 times the absolute value of x minus 2. This next step is perhaps the trickiest step for a lot of people because they're not used to writing proofs like this. They're used to doing, you know, algebra. This is a little bit different. So we have 3 times the absolute value of x minus 2. So we know that the absolute value of x minus 2 is less than delta. So if you wanted to, you could multiply this by 3 and you would get 3 times the absolute value of x minus 2, less than 3 times delta. So then basically this is less than 3 times delta. I want to emphasize that this is not how I think about it. Instead, when I see 3 times the absolute value of x minus 2, I know that the absolute value of x minus 2 is less than delta. So the 3 hangs out, and this whole expression is less than 3 delta. So basically, you can just insert the inequality and replace the absolute value with a delta. That's how people do it. And with practice, you'll be able to do it that way as well. Now, we just make a substitution. Delta is equal to epsilon over 3. This is equal to 3 times epsilon over 3. Oh, look how beautiful this is. And look, the 3s cancel, and so we get epsilon. And so we've satisfied the definition. Since it's a proof, it's always fun to use a symbol to finish our proofs. I like to use a box with an X. Different people end their proofs in different ways. The modern way of finishing a proof is a box and people fill it in. The old school way is QED, which is Latin. I don't remember exactly what it means. I think it's quod et demonstratum or something along those lines. In any case, let's recap what we've done in this problem because this is the basic outline for all of the problems. Some problems are much harder and some are actually a little bit easier. When you first see the problem, your goal is to basically identify, let me switch colors here, let me go to red, identify your a, your f of x, and your l. Your a is 2, your f of x is 3x plus 4, and your l is 10. And then you basically write down the definition, the absolute value of x minus a less than delta. In our case, a was 2. And then you write down your f of x minus l with absolute value. And you just keep playing with it until you make it match your assumption, your piece with your delta. Once you find delta, identify it, circle it, and then you go to your proof. For your proof, you're always going to want to start with let epsilon be greater than 0. And then write choose delta equal to whatever epsilon you found. The hardest part is finding delta in some of these problems. Then you copy the part that says if the absolute value of x minus a is less than delta. In our case, a is 2. And then you go to the, there's a comma here, which you can't see. And then you go to the part with f of x minus l. And the key here is that you don't want to write less than epsilon. You want to actually show it. You basically retrace your steps until you get to the part right here, 3 times the absolute value of x minus 2. Then you know the absolute value of x minus 2 is less than delta. So you put a less than here, and then just replace it with delta. Delta is epsilon over 3, so you plug it in. The 3s cancel, and you end up with epsilon. And we've satisfied the definition. Hopefully, after watching this video, you feel a little bit more confident about writing these proofs. If you've enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Good luck.